How old are you? 21 years old. And she is what relation to you? Your first cousin, right? All right.
I heard what he said. This is what he did to my family. See what I'm saying? This is what he did to my family.
I'm sorry. Why are you so calm? I'm sorry. I don't advocate for violence. But I would imagine when I have a kid, I probably will advocate for violence when crap like this happens to them. What's up with this accent I just put on? I ain't from wherever this accent come from. If this would have been my kid, it would have been a rat. I wouldn't be able to sit next to him like,
here's my cousin, go here, my family.
I would have been like, that would have been my action. Kissa! Channel, and today we are going to be reacting to a father catching his cousin piping his daughter. And yes, I know that sounds crazy, okay, ridiculous. Now this video is over 3 years old. I see the date. A lot of y'all like to come at me like,
oh my god, this video's old.
Well, I ain't seen it and I want to react to it. If you don't like it, you can click off, but come back for the next upload. Yeah, I tend to do a lot of old reactions because some of these videos be good as shit and I never catch them when they're viral because I clearly don't like to scroll, okay? So if you're not aware, we are doing a non-stop November where I post Monday through Friday on this channel, Saturday and Sunday when I feel like it on the second channel, which is my Haitian channel, where I talk about Haitian voodoo, Haitian culture, and growing up as a Haitian American. If you're not subscribed there, what you doing? Also, make sure you guys are tuned into my Wrongfully Convicted podcast where I discuss cases of those who have been wrongfully convicted of crimes they did not do. Join my throne, get your merch. All of this and information you always ask me all the time in the comment section will be down below. Let's get into the mess.
This here is my cousin. Mm-hmm. 21, maybe 22 years old.
He was
this
old.
This is my first cousin's son. His mother and me are first cousins. His grandmother and my father are brother and sister. This is my cousin. First cousin. He's 21.
He so, had to do all that. Put his whole government
on. Oh, tell him what's going on. What is it that you've done?
He looks so ashamed, as he should, though. Actually, I would've put him on blast like this, too.
It's not live or nothing like that. It's not uploading or nothing like that. It's just on my phone, that's it.
This is uploaded. Because I'll be live with that jaw, little salo. Open your mouth, dirty.
Say it loud. You said you messed up, you convinced my daughter to have sex with you. And which daughter is that? My oldest daughter, her name is what? And is that correct?
Yes.
And how old is she?
17.
Say it louder.
17.
And how old are you?
21.
And what is the relation to you?
My cousin.
Your first cousin, right? So, what you're saying now is that you take Tadrian Drayton, who's 21 years old, about to be 22, you convinced your 17-year-old cousin to have sex with you, right?
Right.
I didn't hear you.
Right.
On multiple occasions, right?
Wait, whoa. First of all, can you buy that Raskabuit is this? If you guys do not know what Raskabuit is, it basically means goat family. I don't know how to explain it. Haitians could probably explain it more, but it's basically a term that is used to explain family members that sleep with one another, like sleep with their cousins, sleep with whatever family members. This is disgusting and it's disturbing, and I really hope this father is not just sitting here posting this on the internet and didn't report this man and get him arrested after this. Like, I really hope like it was a double whammy. Like, I'm gonna embarrass you and I'm gonna press charges because this is not okay. And the fact that this is multiple occasions, like, why do y'all do this? Like, why do people who think like this think it's okay to have relations with their family members? Is there not enough people in the world? Like, you couldn't get no coop. from someone that wasn't related to you? You should be ashamed of yourself. And God, hey, look at him trying to look like he's ashamed. He's not ashamed at all. He's just ashamed he got caught. That's nasty. That's nasty. And I'm sure he know they related. It's not one of those situations where, oh, damn, I fucked my cousin. He know they related.
She says on multiple occasions, and like I said, reminds me, the only thing you can do is get the truth out because it's going to come out anyway. So at least it's about maintaining some type of dignity. So say it loud.
Yeah.
You've confessed that I have sex with you on multiple occasions, right? Mm-hmm. You perform oral sex on her and stuff, right? Yeah. Yes? Yeah. And this is your 17-year-old cousin. You are Tajian Drayton. How old are you? 21 years old. And she is what relation to you? Your first cousin, right? All right. This is and I'm heartbroken today. Y'all know me. You see what I'm saying? This is my little cousin. This is my first cousin. My first cousin's son. This is my little cousin. I know him since he was a baby. You understand what I'm saying? And you heard what he said. This is what he did to my family. See what I'm saying? This is what he did to my family.
I'm sorry. Why he so calm? Why he so calm? I'm sorry. I don't advocate for violence. But I would imagine when I have a kid, I probably will advocate for violence when crap like this happens to them. What's up with this accent I just put on? I ain't from wherever this accent come from. If this would have been my kid, it would have been a rat. I wouldn't be able to sit next to him like,
here's my cousin, yo. He hurt my feelings.
I would have been like, that would have been my action. Kisa? No. They would have had to drive me to jail. They would have to drive me to jail. Like, where's Dyfus? I don't understand what's going on here. He's way too calm about this. Like, is this a joke? Is this a hoax? Let me read the comments to see if I'm wasting my time. Because the fact that he's so calm about this is just crazy to me. Like, why are you so calm? I don't know what state they live in, though. To play devil's advocate, I don't know what state they live in. And realistically, I believe in certain states, 16, 17 is usually the age of consent for this type of shenanigans. And plus, you know, they have those Romeo and Juliet laws and all of that. I don't know how this would hold up wherever they from. But it sounds like it was consensual. Like, she clearly wanted to have sex with her cousin. But this is a child. You as the adult should have the common decency to know not to have sex with your cousin and not to have sex with a 17-year-old when you're well over 20, whatever. You feel me? That's just my take on it. Like, I know that there's a lot of us shit. Even me, I've definitely had sex with dudes that were older. They wasn't my cousin. This is wild. If my parents or anyone else would have sat there and tried to like press charges on an older dude that I had sex with, like, I'd be like, nigga, for what? 4 to 5 years doesn't sound like much, but she's 17. Like, you couldn't at least wait till she was 18 and not your cousin. Like, the cousin thing is what's tripping me up, y'all. Like, I can't even play devil's advocate with that. I can play devil's advocate with the age just a tad bit, but the cousin thing is just gross. Like, this whole sleeping with your cousin stuff is just nasty. Like, you telling me you can't find nobody else in the world, all these damn people on this face of this earth, all the people on the block, and this is, you choose to go sleep with your cousin? You think it's okay to go sleep with your underage cousin? Just why? It's ridiculous to me. And just the fact that this is like on the internet, and I hope he's not like roaming around. Like, I would hope that people want to go press charges. Like, I just hope. I really do hope, because no. Like, the whole thing is, the reason I can't really blame her too much, because yes, she's 17, she definitely can make her own decisions. But what a lot of people don't realize is when it comes to anyone under the age of, what is it, like 25? Their prefrontal cortex is not developed, and your prefrontal cortex is responsible for you making decisions. This is why kids do a lot of stupid shit. And this is why a lot of times they're not held 100% accountable, because realistically they're not capable of making sound decisions because they're not able to gauge the consequences of their actions. Like, they clearly know right from wrong. And that's the thing. I feel like a lot of parents and a lot of adults see kids as, okay, well, you're old enough to know right or wrong. You know, stealing is wrong. You know, you shouldn't be having sex at this age. You know that you shouldn't be killing people. Like, they do know this. but they are not able to gauge the consequence of their action. So that's why they'll do certain things and sometimes not even be sorry until years later because they have not come to terms or realized what they've done until they've been severely punished. You know, years have passed by and now they're like, oh damn, like I did that. That's fucked up. That's wild. Like, I'm in some shit. That's why I can't blame her too much, because at the end of the day, she's not the adult in the situation. He is. But comment down below, because I really, really want to hear your input on this. Do you blame him? Do you blame the dad? Do you blame the girl? Do you blame everyone? Honestly, I blame everyone, because what the hell is this? This is your cousin. I'm not getting off of the cousin part.
As he said, he was a
bitch. That beeping is annoying.
My 17-year-old daughter, Kiana, to have sex with him on multiple occasions.
And you ain't gonna do nothing about it. Sex. He better sock his ass.
He convinced her, and this was in gradual stages. So he broke into it, you know, with comments on her body, on her clothes, then on her body, then on specific parts of her body, her vagina, her butt, and all of that. And gradually gained trust with her, and then convinced her to have to get into a sexual relationship with him. This is her cousin. Now, by the definition of this, this is the definition of a sexual predator. We're preying on minors, on young girls who are naive and easy to be manipulated. This is by definition a pedophile.
It is.
This is by definition a child.
And what are you going to do about it? That's what I want to know. Is he going to do anything about it? Is he going to hold him accountable? Is he going to hold her accountable? Now, like I said, I explained why I can't really put too much emphasis on her. But as a father, I want to know if he held her accountable and if he even taught her that shit like this is not okay. Does she know that that's his cousin? Because there's been people related to me and I didn't even know they related to me until later. Luckily, I ain't sleep with them and nothing ever happened, you feel me? But it's like, did you instill the value of just because a dude is trying to say that you look nice or think that you look good or whatever, it doesn't mean you sleep with them? Did you instill the value of you don't have sexual relations with people that are related to us? Did you instill the, you shouldn't even be having sex at 17. You should be focused on school. Like, did you instill that? Like, granted, of course, teens don't listen, but it's like, this is just a very strange circumstance. The way he's acting is strange. The way both of them are acting are quite strange to me. Comment down below, because this is a little off to me. Like, he look calm. Is this a skit? And I didn't read the description. Nah, it don't look like a skit, but.
This is by definition a pervert. And this is my cousin. And this is what he done to my family. And we are Muslims. You understand what I'm saying? We are Muslims. So you already know how I'm taking this. It's killing me. Tasian Dream. But one more time for the record. Is it true that you convinced your 17-year-old? I hear you.
Yes. He looks so pathetic.
This is what he's saying. He's
at least say it with your chest, nasty.
This 21-year-old, maybe 22-year-old man has been molesting my daughter. My firstborn child, my 17-year-old. This is what he did to all of us as a family. This is what he did to me and my household. That's what I want y'all to see and understand. See what I'm saying? He said he convinced her. He convinced her. You see what I'm saying? Meaning that she wasn't necessarily interested in that initially. He convinced her to do that. Like we all used to convince young, naive girls when we were younger. This is what we have here, y'all. I just want y'all to see and hear it for yourself. Assalamu alaikum.
Now, I'm so sorry if you guys were bothered by that fucking beeping or whatever, that noise in the background. That's just freaking annoying. It annoyed me too. I don't like how he's trying to make it seem like his daughter was innocent. I definitely don't believe she was innocent in all of this. Trust me, I don't. I do believe that as an adult, he should have made the rational decision to not mess with a child. That's just common sense. Should both be held accountable. And if he did nothing about it but make a Facebook video, humiliate him, and probably yell at him, he should be held accountable. He is way too calm for a father that just found out that his cousin was touching his daughter. To be completely honest with you, I don't believe in violence, but in this case, he would have got beat the fuck up. I would have told this man, square up or go to jail. Pick one. That's exactly what I said. I would have been like, square up or go to jail. Which one are you gonna pick? Like, you either get beat the fuck up or you get locked up. I'd rather take the beating. I don't know about you. I feel like we need to start teaching our daughters not to be manipulated by this type of shit. And realistically, most girls who have their head on 100% straight and aren't lacking anything in their upbringing don't fall for this type of shit. I feel like I was lacking a lot of guidance. I didn't really have, like, I had an older sister, but she wasn't that much older than me. She was only 6 months older than me. I didn't have any other siblings. My parents were, like, always working or just, like, never around. So, it's like, I got the attention, I guess, when I needed it, but I didn't have much guidance. So, there was a lot of shit I just genuinely did not know. Like, so, I would fall into shit knowing, like, oh, maybe I shouldn't be doing this, but, I mean, I have no one to really tell me I shouldn't be doing it, so I'm gonna do it anyway. And I had a whole lot of people around me that were doing the same shit. So for me, I feel like I just had the lack of guidance and everyone was doing the same shit. So I just thought it was okay. Which is crazy because now that I think back at it, like, it definitely wasn't okay. And I can't say I wholeheartedly knew. But I can say that I was not able to gauge the problem with it in my head at all. Because no one sat down and told me straight up, like, these dudes will use you, they will abuse you, they will manipulate you because you're young and they think you're dumb. No one ever sat there and told me that. I had my parents always tell me, don't take shit from no nigga. I had them tell me, don't play with boys. I've had them tell me, like, other stuff in terms of don't let a nigga play you type shit, but not, like, we'll be manipulated. They will make you try to do this. They, like, you know, Haitian parents don't do that. They don't sit around telling their kids stuff like that. And I really wish more Caribbean parents, foreign parents especially, would feel more comfortable talking about certain situations with their kids because it can save them, it can save their lives. I know a lot of Haitian kids now who have, like, American born parents or just, like, you know, like, parents who came here a little later, and they instill that within their kids. They're like, yo, don't be doing that shit. And they stay in their books. They don't be in no bullshit until they get to college. But then again, I feel like most people I know who, damn, this sounds so horrible. This is gonna come out the right way, but comment down below if you understand what I'm trying to say and if you agree. I've been a firm believer that when you go through shit when you're younger, you're less likely to go to more shit as an adult. Like, I went through so much shit in my teen years, in my younger adult life, that now can't nobody touch me, can't nobody faze me. I call bullshit from a mile away. I would have preferred not to go through all the shit that I went through, but I know a lot of people who, like, lost their virginities in college and, you know, just never been through anything until college. Now they're suffering and they're, like, 30 still accepting fuckboys that I was with in, like, when I was, like, 19. And it's like, nigga, like, you're 30 now. Like, how you can't see through this mess. So comment down below. Would you prefer your kid to go through something like that when they're younger? Would you prefer your kids to go through something like that when they're younger in terms of bad relationships or just, like, bad situations instead of dealing with it in their adulthood? Because people may argue that, okay, since they're younger, it may fuck them up in the long run. While some people may say that, you know, since they're older, they're able to handle these things more rationally when they are older and they're able to gauge right from wrong as well as just be well-rounded in that type of situation as opposed to when they're younger where it can do more damage. I don't know. I feel like I would prefer my kid to go through a lot of shit while they're younger so they don't go to college where it actually matters. Because, like, if I'm paying thousands of dollars for my kid to be in college and they're sitting here crying over fuck niggas not going to class, bitch, I'll be mad as fuck because I'm paying for that in terms of them going through a fuck nigga or some girl breaking his heart or whatever, and now he ain't going to class and I'm paying thousands of dollars for it. Like, I don't know. Comment down below. It's just, I don't know, it's just a thought. But this is disgusting. And what's really crazy, and I ain't gonna call no names, I ain't gonna speak on it any further, but I know a lot of people who are married to their cousins, had babies with their cousins. I think it's absolutely weird. I think it's disgusting, and I do not think it's okay. And to be honest, if you're one of those people, yuck. Like, I literally almost threw up just now. I would never touch any of my cousins in that way. It's disturbing. I don't care how good your cousin look. Oh my God, the fact that anyone could look at their family members that way is a problem. Guys, oh God, please seek psychological help. Comment down below if you know anyone who does this nonsense. Comment down below what you think about this video. Make sure you guys like, share, subscribe. I'm gonna go throw up. And I'm gonna see y'all next time.